Hello students, welcome back to the next and the last session of NumPy. So we were just doing the revision of NumPy so that it will be helpful to the first unit, which is Python pandas. So let us start the topic. Today we will discuss about slice. Okay, so all of you must be well acquainted with the term slicing. Slicing means just you are using the term slice of pizza, slice of bread. It means we don't want it as whole. We want a piece. We want a part of the whole piece. Similarly, beta, in the previous session, we have discussed how to display the whole array as well as how to access a single element of the array. But what if we want a part of the array, a slice of the array? And for that, we are having this operation slicing. Now slicing can be performed on the array. Okay, so today we will discuss about slicing, and one more thing, it is stacking. Okay, so let us start the slicing. What is slicing and how we can perform the slicing? So today we will perform slicing on both between one dimensional array and two dimensional array. And slicing, for slicing we have to use this operator, and this operator is known as colon operator. Okay, this one is known as colon operator. So we take first two things are needed to be passed, at least two things are needed to be passed while slicing. So suppose we are passing one starting value and one ending value, then slicing will be done from this first value and not up to the last. It will be last less than one. Okay, so previously we have done already like this. So again, you may give step also. Step will do what? If nothing is written, it means step is one. If you will give step as two, then one element will be skipped. We will start from the starting value, then we have to move up to n minus 1, and then if you will give any step value 2, 3, 4 like that, then that many elements you have to skip in between start and end. If nothing is given, then step will be 1, means we have to move sequentially from start position to the end position. And suppose if we have not written anything for the start value, then it will be considered as starting value will be 0. Starting position will be what? 0. We have to do bit slicing, and for slicing we have to give the position. We have to mention the index value of the element. Okay, so if we are writing a start and end, it means we are providing two index values. If you have not given any start index value, then by default it will take the start position from beginning. It will consider it as 0. And if you will skip the end value, then by default it will consider the end value will be the last element of that array. Okay, and if you will not give any step value, then by default it will be considered as 1. So these things have been written in these lines. Okay, if we don't pass start, it's considered 0. If we don't pass n, it considered length of array in that dimension. If we don't pass step, it is considered as 1. Okay, so we will see these things practically also today. Now suppose we are having one dimensional array. Okay, this is one dimensional array. So previously in the I told you that these are the index, these are the positive index and these are the negative index. So slicing can be done by using both positive and negative index. So suppose you are writing 1:5 and between nothing is written for the third parameter, it means we are having step value as 1. So the starting value will be what? 1. Now remember, starting value 1 means the index value 1. So which is the index value? Index value 1 is here, and we have to move up to which index value? It is 5, but we have to move up to 5 less than 1. So we have to move up to 5 less than 1. So we have to move to 1, then 2 also, because step value is 1. We have not written anything, it means step value will be 1. So answer will be 1, then 2, then 3, then 4, not 5, because 1 value less than the last index, the end index. Okay, so If you will see the output bit, let us see. See, here we are. We have the same code, okay? And when we are executing this bit, when we are slicing, we are having the output 2, 3, 4, 5. You can see here. Sorry, you can see here. This one is 2, 3, 4, 5. What are the elements stored in the respective index bit? These are 2, then 3, then 4, and then 5. Okay, because what index value we are getting after slicing is 1 to 4, but in the result what we will have, we will have the elements stored in that particular index. So the elements will be 2, 3, 4, and 5. Okay, so next, what we are having, Bete? Suppose we are having this code. Okay, we have to mention at least two index. First one is start index and second one is the end index. If end index is not given, it means by default we have to move up to the last index value. So can you tell me, Bete, what should be the output? We have to start from which index? We have to start from the index 4. And how many elements from index 4 up to the last, because no end index is given. So let us coming back to the example, and which is the fourth index, Bete? This one is the fourth index, and from fourth index we want how many elements up to last. So output should be what, Bete? 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, so let us check what we are getting. Already I have written the code so that it should not take the time. Okay, so where we have to start? We have to start from the index 4. So which is index 4? This one is 0, this one is 1, 2, 3, 4. This is the fourth index, and fourth index, from fourth index to the last index. So output should be 5, 6, and 7. Okay, so coming back to here, so in this question we were having only 7 elements. In this example we were having only 9 elements. Okay, so if we are having only 7 elements, then output should be 5, 6, and 7. Okay, then let us discuss about the negative index. Okay, so for negative index, Bete, if we want to do the negative slicing, then what we have to do? The very first thing you have to keep in mind, Bete, then when we are passing two indexes, first one is start index and second one is the end index, then the start index must be less than the end index. If you are giving any random value, that means if start value is greater than the end index value, then your array will be empty. So try to give some genuine value so that the slicing can be done on the array. So now see, we have written what? Starting value is -3 and ending value is -1. Let us check, Bete. Suppose we are having only 7 elements. In this particular example we are having only 7 elements, but in this one we are having 9. So let us consider that up to 7 elements we are having, and we are talking about negative index. So if we will have only 7 elements and we will talk about negative index, then 7 will have which index? -1, -2, and -3. So we have to start from -3, and then we have to take how many elements? -3 to -1. So -3, -2, -1, and it will be what? It will be less than the last index. Okay, so this is -1, this is -2, this is -3. So how many elements will be in the result, Bete? It will be, the starting value will be -3, so starting value will be 5. Then we have to proceed, since step is 1, then next value will be 6. Now tell me whether 7 will be taken. No, it won't, because we have to take 1 less than the last index. So in the output we will have only 5 and 6. Let us check, Bete. In the output we will have only 5 and 6, because remember, Bete, this one is excluded. The end index is excluded. We have to move up to the n index minus 1. Okay. So similarly, in two-dimensional array, we can also perform the slicing. Okay. So two-dimensional array, we can also perform the slicing. So, but you have to keep in mind the two-dimensional array is having two indexes, one for row and one for column. So if we will perform slicing in 2D arrays, what we have to do, we have to give the two slicing, one for which one? One for row and one for column. Okay. So suppose here we are having two-dimensional array. Okay. And this slicing will be performed for what? This slicing will be performed for row and this slicing will be performed for column. Okay, bete. So I have written what? I have written 1 colon, then nothing is written. Nothing means we have to move up to the last row. This is talking about the row slicing and this is talking about the column slicing. I told you that first one is for row and next one is for column. So this will tell about the row slicing. So we have to move from which row, bete? We have to move from the first row. Since we are having only two rows, first row is having 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and second row will be 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And we have to start from first row, then the row considered will be this one. Okay. But from this row, we don't want all the elements. We want how many elements, bete? We have to take the column 1, 2 and 3, not 4, less than 4. So we have to start from 1. We don't need the 0th one. So this one is the 0th one. So just skip the 6. We have to start from first column to the third column. So this is first column. This is second column. This is third column. So output is 7, 8 and 9. Okay. So these were all about slicing, bete. This is a little bit complicated, but the practice will make you perfect. Okay. So if any doubt you are having, just ask me there. So next we will discuss about joining. We can combine, bete, two arrays. Two arrays means two one-dimensional arrays can be combined, as well as two-dimensional arrays can also be combined. And to combine them, we are having one concatenate function. Okay, so this is very simple. Just you have to use concatenate function and it will do the job. What you have to do, bete? Suppose we are having two one-dimensional array. This is array 1 having elements 1, 2 and 3. And array 2 having elements 4, 5, 6. Okay. And we want to create a new array after concatenating array 1 and array 2. Concatenating means bete, combining, appending. Okay. So the array 2 elements will be concatenate with the array 1 elements. So the resultant array will be what? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Because this was one-dimensional array, this was one-dimensional array, and after concatenating, we are getting again one-dimensional array whose elements are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Okay, let us see. Okay, so this one was very simple because both are one-dimensional array. Let us combine two-dimensional array and see what result we are getting with it. Okay. Now here we are having two-dimensional arrays, okay, array 1 and array 2. Now two-dimensional array can be concatenate also. You have to keep in mind, bete, when we are concatenating two-dimensional array, shape must be same. Shape must be same, matlab both the arrays must have same number of rows and same number of columns. Only then concatenation is possible, okay. Only then we can join two arrays. So when we are talking about this array, array 1, then it will be like this one. And when we are talking about array 2, this will be like this one. Okay. Now see, bete, I'm using here concatenate function, which two array is going to be combined, array 1 and array 2, but one additional thing I have passed, access is equal to 1. What does it mean? Access is equal to 1 means that if I want to combine these two array row wise, means this is the first row of the array 1 2, so the first row of first array will be combined to the first row of the second array, and the second row of the first array will be combined to the second row of the second array. So row wise combination will be there, so our result will be something like this. So if you want row wise concatenation, then you have to write here access equal to 1. Okay, so just see here, I have written access is equal to 1 bete, and what we are getting, that row of first row of the first array is combined with the first row of the second array, and second row of the first array is combined with the second row of the second array. So in case of access is equal to 1, access wise concatenation is going on. And similarly, if you will write access is equal to 0, what will happen, Betty? Yes, you are correct. Column wise concatenation will be there. It means first column of the first array will combine with the first column of the second array, and second column of the first array will be combined with the second column of the second array. Let us check the result. It will be something like this. Now see, here column wise concatenation is going on. Okay, then the next one and the last one is with a stacking. Okay, stack, using stack function, the concatenation is done. We have done the we have joined the array using concatenate function, and the same thing can be done by using stack function also. So we are having two stack functions in NumPy bete. First one is vstack, that is vertically stack, and next one is hstack, that is horizontally stack. Just now we have discussed that what will happen when access will be 1 and when access will be 0. Now the same thing can be done by using vstack and hstack also. Now if you have written vstack, then what will happen with a row wise combination will be there. Now see here, we are having array 1, array 2, and if you will write vstack, then row wise concatenation will be done. Okay, and if it is hstack, now the output will be like this. Okay, so let us check the output. Here we are having vstack, so the output is like this. Now see, it is done in one dimensional array. The same thing you can try in two dimensional array as well, and you can check what output you are getting. So if you are writing vstack, it means vertical stack. The first time in the 1D array 1 and 1D array 2 are vertically stacked among themselves and have given the new array, this one. Okay, this is the vertical stack. And then when we are talking about horizontal stack, it means the elements are combined horizontally row wise, then you have to use h stack. Okay, so I have explained these stacking using 1D array. You can do the practice on 2D array as well. Okay, so this was all about beta NumPy. And this was the last session of the NumPy, and from the next session we will start Python pandas, which is the most important part of your syllabus because it comprises of the most weightage. In the first session I told you the weightage, the marks distribution of the your whole syllabus. So the Python pandas is the most important syllabus, so I hope you will be cleared about up to this session. So if you are having any doubt, ask me, and if you find my video useful, then don't forget to like, share and subscribe. So thank you for watching, Bete. Bye, take care.